Welcome to WebStylePress. If you are new here, consider subscribing and hit bell icon. Previously, I shared a video about using images in ReactJS. In that, I talked about alternative to importing each image separately. I said you could require all images in a file, then import that file in component, then you can point to any image in that file to display it. This helps in assets organization, and it takes only one import rather than many images imports separately. This is a single import. This is actually this index.js file from this images folder. This index.js file that is being imported, and then we are pointing images from this index.js file. In this index.js, this is const images, and then these are the images that we have required, and we have used .default. You may not need this .default. If your required doesn't work, you can use .default, then it will work. So this is an image. This is an image we have required, and this is also an image with their names, and then we can reference these names from this object or this module. We have exported this object as images, then we have imported that module here with the name of images, and then by using this images dot logo react. This is logo react that will render this image, and similarly logo angular logo view. This is my app, and I've got src folder, and src folder contains images folder, and these are my images. This is that index.js file. Now I have got this home folder. It has got home.png. I have got about folder, it has got about.png, and then about.svg file. So we have got more images in separate folders. Let's see what we can do with these. I hope this story is clear. I will link previous video in description as well, in case you want to see that as well. In that video, I missed something. You can nest blocks inside other blocks of code. You can further arrange these images into their own categories. For example, let's say you have got home component and you have got about component. We can arrange home and about images separately in this code structure. Now we are kind of arranging images in categories. We want to require images from these folders in a way that these should be categorized or separate from this structure. Inside this structure, home colon, let's copy this, and then home icon, and that is in the home folder with the name of home.png. Similarly, we have got about. About icon that is in folder about with the name of about.png. Then there's the second image about icon svg in the same folder about with the name of about.svg. Save. Now we have got these images. Then we have got more images in separate structure. Consider this is for a component with the name home, and this is for a component about, and these are images, and these images belong to about component, and this image belongs to home component. That is why we are categorizing these images or separating these images for effective assets management. And then we can call these inside our main component like this: images dot about dot about icon. This is one import that we will require. And then from images home, home icon, two more, about icon, about icon SVG. And this code editor suggests the path images dot about dot. See, it is suggesting about icon SVG. As you can see, our images have been loaded here. Home icon and then two about, and we displayed SVG image as well. You can use SVGs in ReactJS. You can use SVG like this. Just require SVG image. And it will be like img src and then SVG path inside that source, image source. You can use SVG like this, or you can place SVG code directly in component, or you can also import SVG as React component. If you want to change color and size for the SVG, then you need to use SVG code directly or import it as React component. But that is for another video. For now, remember this structure that can be used to effectively arrange images into categories. Alright guys, give this video a like, subscribe to channel and press bell icon. This will help the channel and motivate me to create more videos. Stay tuned and I will see you in the next video.